All right, everybody. Time for the first game. Let's battle. All right, we got our opponent. This hand is just good enough. Gotta be really careful with two power hands, especially on the play. And especially without crest, but we have three power, we have a favor. Makes the hand a little slower, which is a bit awkward for champion. But we have shakedown, so we also have a chance to just naturally draw a power. And the hand is quite good all in all. Too good to redraw, I think. I played a banner here. But yeah, one of the best ways to lose with the deck is this favor wasn't there. Don't keep this hand, it's just gonna lose you games you shouldn't be losing. Right. I think the right play here is to use favor to the face. Especially because we have another one if our opponent plays a Hoyan or Baby Ikaria, for example, and it allows us to play a champion next turn and even play it around, say, Vanquish and stuff because it's a 3-3. And then we'll just delay the shakedown a bit, like, before we attack. Well, if that's our draw, I might just go... Yeah, I think I go for shakedown here now. Because it also lets us take a potential merchant and dodge it. That's a defiance, that's a pretty good dodge regardless. Here we just attack. And thanks to drawing another 2-drop, we can do this and then play the 2-drop. Be power efficient. Yeah, things are looking pretty decent here. This is enough pressure until like Harshful rolls around. Let's hit some. The card is like very bad against the deck, but there are corner cases like this where it is good and the opponent drew it off the top so we don't see it coming. But this very rarely does anything. And it doesn't really do much against most decks these days, so I think the card's pretty bad right now. So don't worry too much about it. But yeah, this was a bit unfortunate that the opponent drew into this. Like, had it in his deck, even though it's not very good, drew into it, and we presented them with the rare board state where it actually is good. And another card the opponent just drew into. Now it's my turn. But we still got plenty of gas in the tank. But it's gonna be one of the tougher games for the reason of him kind of getting lucky with the hailstorm there. But yeah, we didn't really have a good way around the hailstorm. And the good lists don't run it. Like, if you look at the lists that top 8ed, that were basically my main deck, with a bit different market that Zach Hill and his friend top 8ed the last DCQ, then you see there's no hailstorm. So this player probably cut like Island's Choice or something, which is actually really good for us, because Island's Choice stops you from dying to obliterate and is another great removal for the high impact threats. Okay. That works for me. Here we just play Maiden, because I want to play another threat. Actually, no, I don't play Maiden. I actually just get rid of Maiden. I think that's better. Get a Highwayman. So we have something to follow up if there is like a Harshful now, which is very possible. And Maiden is just not a great card to have. Like, together with like the 6-spot removal and power you don't need, the worst card in the deck in the matchup anyway. Okay. That. Gotta do this here now. Punish the hammer. But it seems like there is no harsh roll. I think the opponent would have harsh rolled. But no, I don't know. Maybe the opponent is delaying it because of the rune hypocrisy. Is that gonna be... See? Having the desecrate here will come in surprisingly handy. Hitting the warden. Thanks to the Vara. Out of a card that otherwise doesn't do a whole lot. And getting quick draw on this, which is really, really good in the face of the 2-2. Harsh rule now. The opponent doesn't have a harsh rule. Things are going real tough. Would assume there is a harsh rule. Don't know for sure. Nope, no harsh rule. Well, that's great. That means opponent might even die. They probably have something. I figured that choice might be the market card the opponent got there. But yeah, that allows us to play champion here. Opponent has to top deck a harsh rule, basically. And we have a lot of burn. Basically can burn out the opponent over 2 turns. Yeah, I think I just obliterate here this. And use Dark Return on either Merchant or Highwayman when it dies, or Vara to break the Aegis. That's our lethal. Ah, yeah, it's exactly lethal. Unless the opponent has something. Okay, that helps. I think we have to get Vara now over Highwayman. Break the Aegis so we can desecrate this. That's quite good. Also something that very questionable to be in the deck in the first place. But it does the job here. Was a pretty good comeback from the opponent, fortunately. Something catch your eye. What the hell? Okay. Oh. We just play the frog. They kill it with a weapon, it's still a damage to the face. And drawing a fire source for this will do a lot. Cool. Yep, there we go. That is lethal. The opponent doesn't have something else that gets this, so that's game. Ooh, what a close game. But yeah, as you can see, the deck can go fairly long and win drawn-out games even against something like Horror Control. If the opponent would have gotten like Scorch or Frost Home instead of this thing, the game might have looked a little different. But fortunately they didn't. Alright, that's the first game. Pretty nice showing of the deck and the matchup, actually. So yeah, we got 3 more games to go. So see you in a moment with game number 2.